This video will cover the first time login from a gamer's perspective. So the assumption at this point is that you've downloaded the installer on a gaming PC to review, and now you're exploring the default functionality. And so this is how the ggLeap 3.0 client appears by default with no customizations. So you can change the ggCircuit logo to your own logo, and you can change the colors to match your brand guidelines. And you can also change the background video. This is just a default, so you can upload a custom video or static images to the web administrator, reboot the PC, and the client will boot with that content. And you'll notice that the login panel itself will disappear when nobody is using the PC, so that your media will be given full screen real estate when nobody is using the PC. But as soon as I interact with the keyboard or mouse, the login panel will reappear. So on the login panel itself, gamers can instantly translate the language to any of these available languages here, which is great if you have tourists. And gamers can also create an account directly at the PC, should you choose to allow that, as well as at reception or on the dynamic web page that's available as well. So for this video, I will go ahead and create an account. And I can either do that through one of the SSO options or register manually. I'll go for the manual option in this case. The information that is gathered on this screen, including what is mandatory and what is optional, is defined on the web administrator. So these are the defaults, but it can be completely configured as to your choosing. Okay, so we have successfully created an account manually. We're going to press the continue button to attempt to log in. Now at this point, because the account we've created doesn't actually have any game time associated with their account, the user is taken to the time over shop, which is a limited version of the point of sale system where gamers can purchase gaming time or redeem coins that they have earned with in the prize vault, which we'll cover in a later video. For now, I'm just going to go ahead and try and buy 2 hours of gaming time. Now at this point, the gamer has four options. They can either pay from their ggLeap balance if they've previously chosen to deposit money to you for this purpose. They can pay later, which will start a post-pay session. This must be configured on the web administrator if you should choose to allow that. They can also pay now using their phone, which will allow them to scan a QR code. Again, this must be configured on the web administrator. Or they can summon a human, which will send a message to staff to say that a user needs to have a payment collected from them. So for the purposes of the video, since none of these are configured and the user doesn't have any account balance, I'll click the summon a human button. And this will take the user to the finalization stage where they can confirm that this is what they would like to do. And at this point, a message has now been sent to staff to tell them that a customer is waiting for a payment. If the user does click the button to go back, you'll notice that there remains a little icon at the top just to confirm what is happening, and the user is now waiting.